How close are you to the newest member of the Laker family?
Well, he's part of the Laker family.
Right.
So when he first came on board, I said, listen, is there anything you need? You are now family now. You're part of this tradition. So if there's anything you need, just let me know.
Has he needed anything?
No, I think he's fine.
Welcome back to The Jump. That was Kobe Bryant on SportsCenter last night here in this studio. And I'm Rachel Nichols, joined by George Sedano and Paul Pierce. So I want to just get into that interesting moment at the Lakers game last night that involved Kobe. The Lakers are sitting there. They're winning their second straight game. LeBron's messing around to get a triple-double. Kobe's sitting courtside. And Lakers fans noticed. I want to take a little listen here. So LeBron sort of ends that chant by hitting a pretty good three-pointer. After the game, Kobe Bryant told The Athletic and the LA Times that LeBron James being a Laker is, quote, I can't even do the quote there.
Bleeping awesome.
There we go. Being here in this building, seeing the fans, seeing the energy back in the place, it's awesome. So Paul, Kobe, and look, Kobe came on our show after LeBron was acquired by the Lakers and said, everyone who roots for me should root for LeBron. Kobe has said publicly in several different forums, hey, if you're a Laker fan, you should be a LeBron fan. And yet there does seem to be this undercurrent of people who are sort of want to chant for him instead of for the guys on the court. Is that a bad look? Is it okay?
It's a great look. I mean, you have one of your legends come into the building for a game. Let me tell you, Kobe doesn't come to the games. He rarely comes to the games.
It's only the second time since he retired.
So he's in the building. The fans adore him. Of course they're going to give him a chance. Every time he does that, because he rarely comes. Of course, it doesn't matter who's playing. LeBron, Kobe's in the building, you're going to hear his name chanted every single time.
Yeah, bad look. No, this is a great look, okay? I think that if anything, there needs to be more of this, where LeBron and Kobe are in the same building. Kobe gets to be shown reverence. LeBron gets to win the game, right? Like, that will make everyone happy. But, I mean, there's no shock that a guy who won five titles for that team is going to get cheered. That's exactly what they should do, and good on Laker fans.
Right, and Paul, look, you had this as well, right? You had former Celtics who would come in the building while you were there.
Of course.
Right? And I guess it's a little different because when they would come in the building, I guess, old Kobe video, when it's just fun to watch, when they would come in the building and people would cheer for them.
Yes.
You didn't play against them, right? So LeBron and Kobe played each other and were rivals for a long time. Whereas if a former, I don't know, Larry Bird, right, would come in the building, everyone was like,
they chant Larry.
They chant Larry,
you know what?
And it was
years,
fine
Larry
with you.
Only came back once.
Yeah. Really?
Only once.
Well,
as the GM.
I was going to say.
During the Pacers series.
As an executive
in the playoffs.
For another team. But yeah, like if Larry Bird's in the building and they're chanting Larry, 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 no one's thinking that's disrespectful of you because it's just.
But you got to understand,
lineage.
LeBron and Kobe weren't really rivals. They were just considered at one point the two best players in the league.
The Nike puppet commercial.
Yeah,
puppets are think differently.
The puppets weren't rivals, but it never manifested.
Don't knock
everybody
on those puppets. Hey. I love
everybody
those puppets.
Everybody thought Kobe and LeBron would meet in the finals during those years.
I love those puppets.
My Twitter thinks differently, Paul.
Boston interrupted that a little bit.
Yeah.
Because you know the whole campaign of LeBron and Kobe, it never came to fruition because of the Celtics.
It didn't, because of you guys and weirdly the Orlando Magic.
Right, Dwight.
We thought that it was going to
happen. Yeah, Dwight and Stan. Yeah,
in 2009, we thought that was the year we thought because you guys had KG hurt and then.
Well,
And
the Dallas Mavericks. Let's not forget about that when Andrew Bynum clotheslined poor J.J. Barea in that series.
It never really became the rivalry everybody thought it would be.
Yes. Well, absolutely. And look, they have both been very complimentary of each other.
Yeah.
So, George, I think you're right that there's a section of the fan base that wants to pit them against each other. If over these next few months they continue to say this isn't a thing, hopefully it won't be a thing. All right. Now is the moment that I've been waiting for the entire show.
Oh, this is my favorite part of the show.
So good.
La La Land.
Shout out Producer Tucker, Producer Carlos. Every time last night, La La Land was definitely making a dance. He provided an enormous boost for the Lakers, both ends of the court, especially late in the fourth quarter. He sparked a 15-2 rally with back-to-back three-pointers, finished with 12 points, and after the game, LeBron James gave the props. Take a listen.
I think Lance just picked up where he left off from last night in Phoenix. And, you know, he's the reason he kind of sparked this when we kind of fell in that hole early in the fourth quarter. You know, his tenacity, his competitive nature just kind of brought us back into that game. Whatever, I mean, listen, when Lance steps on the floor, you know, he's the spark for us. You know, he doesn't have to score to make an impact. But he's done it the last two nights, and you know, it's worked wonders for our team, that's for sure.
Let me tell you something. Lance Stephens, let me tell you something. He has the loudest 12 points in the league.
Right?
Because you feel like you
he
see his 12
game.
Points that he didn't have like 30 or 40.
Right.
I mean, this team is living up. I will say, we're only through, what, four or five games of the season?
Five games.
Team is living up to being as entertaining as promised.
They have been fun
almost every night to watch, win or lose. And Lance, I mean, I don't know, can you say what you'd expect from him this season, Paul? Because it's not all good, but it's not all bad either.
Yep. It's going to be like the stock market with Lance. It's going to be just like this. Mm-hmm. Just like that one play we saw with Lance.
Right.
You're going to have days like that, and then you're going to have good Lance. You got good Lance and bad Lance.
Days? You're going to have minutes where you have good Lance and bad Lance.
We just saw it in that game.
Right?
Look, I kind of alluded to this earlier, right? I look at the Lakers as a dinner plate. LeBron is the meat, right? Okay. Then the young guys are the side dishes. Lance is that after-dinner coffee. Not every night you're going to want
coffee?
The after-dinner coffee.
Wait, after-dinner coffee?
Yeah, or drink, you know, perhaps. Whatever your drink of choice may be. But not every night you're going to want a port. Or you're going to want a coffee, right? Some nights you do, some nights you don't.
Sedano.
Yeah.
There you go. I like that. So what? Lonzo's vegetable in this scenario?
Yeah, you could be like the, you know, mashed potatoes or something, or or some asparagus, or you know.
I love Lance. I mean, I love Lance.
Oh my God.
I mean, I can't believe he hasn't stuck in one place for a long period of time.
Whoa.
I mean, he's exciting. He's
well, we know why.
You can't believe. You know, I was going to say, you know why?
I don't. I
mean, is he the most?
Lance is a good guy, man.
No one is arguing that. No one is arguing that, but your whole thing about this on the court, it wears on some people.
Yeah. Is he the most memeable player in the NBA or gifable
player on that team? You've got competition for that even on that team.
That's what I'm saying. But he might be the top of the mountain there with those guys, I guess.
And it's only October, people. We got so much more to go.
Only four games in, y'all.
Right?